Magandang tanghali po sa ating mga kababayan at sa mga miyembro ng Malacañang Press Corps. Mula po dito sa PTV Davao, maing udto sa ato mga kigsuunan, gikan diri sa Davao. Humarap kagabi si Pangulong Rodrigo Roa Duterte sa taong bayan sa kanyang lingguhang Talk to the People address. Idineklara ng Pangulo ang State of Calamity sa mga lugar na naapektuhan ng Bagyong Odette. Kasama rito ang Regions 4B, 6, 7, 8, 10, and 13. Ito ay para mapabilis ang rescue, relief, and rehabilitation efforts ng pamahalaan at sa sinumang gustong tumulong. Isa rin itong mabisang mekanismo para makontrol ang presyo ng mga bilihin sa mga nasabing lugar. Ipinag-utos din ng Pangulo ang pag-release ng pondo para tulungan ang mga taong naapektuhan ng Bagyong Odette. Mamaya ay makakasama natin ang ating mga panauhin, si Civil Defense Deputy Administrator for Operations, Assistant Secretary Casiano Munilla, at Department of Budget and Management OIC Secretary Tina Rose Canda para magbigay ng detalye at iba pang mga bagay tungkol sa State of Calamity. Mamayang hapon ay inaasahan natin ang Pangulo na ipagpatuloy ang pagbisita sa mga lugar na sinalanta ng Bagyong Odette. Later, he is scheduled to visit Siargao and the Dinagat Islands. Updates regarding his visit to these areas will be issued right after. Sa gitna ng trahedya, nakita natin na buhay ang bayanihan spirit. Nagpapasalamat kami sa Metro Manila Mayors who approved a supplemental budget sa pamamagitan ng isang resolusyon na nagkakalaga ng 100 million pesos para tulungan ang mga lugar na naapektuhan ng Bagyong Odette. We are likewise grateful to our friends in the international community, partners and allies for their offers of assistance. These include Australia, Canada, China, the European Union, France, Japan, the United Kingdom, the United States of America, the United Nations, and the State of Qatar, among others. Maraming salamat po sa inyo. So, sa ping bakuna, binabati natin ang lahat mula sa ating vaccinators at volunteers hanggang sa ating mga mamamayan sa kanilang pakikilahok sa second run ng ating National Vaccination Days. Tulad ng nai-report ni Department of Health Secretary Francisco Duque kagabi sa Talk to the People, maliban sa 84 na mga local government units na nagkansela ng kanilang bakunahan, nasa 100% functional vaccination operations ang lahat ng mga LGUs. Mula December 15 hanggang December 21, nasa 5,056,186 ang ating nabakunahan. Ayon sa National Vaccination Operations Center, as of December 22, 2021, 5 a.m. Binabati natin ang mga regions na nalampasan ang kanilang mga target. Region 1, for surpassing its 202,224 National Vaccination Days Round 2 target. Nakapagbakuna sila ng 364,806 or 180.4%. Pumapangalawa ang Region 2 na mayroong 128,991 target. Ang kanilang cumulative jabs ay 179.51%. Congratulations po sa inyo. Binabati rin namin ang Cordillera Administrative Region na nakakuha ng 118.45% ng kanilang target ay 68,247. Ang nabakunahan nila ay nasa 80,837. Next are Region 10 na naka-accomplish ng 103.65%, ang National Capital Region with 102.74%, at Region 9 na nasa 100.36%. As of December 21, 2021, ayon sa National COVID-19 Dashboard, nasa 102,995,133 ang total vaccines na ating na-administer. nasa 58.71% ng target population or mahigit 45 million ang fully vaccinated. Habang nasa 78.06% ng target population or mahigit 60 million ang nakatanggap ng first dose. Isang paalala po mula sa Department of Health, effective today, December 22, 2021, all adults na nasa edad 18 at pataas ay pwede nang tumanggap ng single dose booster ng COVID-19 vaccine at least 3 months pagkaraan nilang makatanggap ng second dose ng AstraZeneca, Moderna, Pfizer, Sinovac, or Sputnik vaccine, or at least 2 months pagkatapos nilang makatanggap ng Janssen. Isa pa rin paalala, ang booster doses ay hindi po natin nirerekomenda sa edad 12 hanggang 17 anyos. Hindi po napigilan ni Typhoon Odette, mga kababayan, ang pagdating ng mga bakuna. Dumating kagabi, December 21, ang 1,358,600 doses ng Moderna vaccine na binili ng pribadong sektor. Samantala, dumating din kahapon, December 21, ang 500,000 doses ng AstraZeneca vaccine na donasyon mula sa Argentina. Dalawang batches ng Pfizer vaccine donations mula sa Estados Unidos ang ating natanggap. Dumating ang unang batch noong Lunes, December 20, na binubuo ng 1,776,060 doses. Samantalang kahapon, Martes, December 21, ay dumating ang second batch na binubuo ng 1,623,960 doses. Natanggap din natin kahapon, Martes, December 21, ang 1,697,000 doses ng AstraZeneca vaccine na donasyon mula sa bansang France. Bago nito, nakatanggap tayo sa France ng 811,980 doses ng Pfizer vaccine noong Sabado, December 18. Nasa 1,062,100 doses naman ng Moderna vaccine mula sa donasyon ng bansang Germany ang dumating sa Pilipinas noong Linggo, December 19. Samantala, noong Linggo rin, December 19, dumating ang private sector procured na 663,400 doses ng AstraZeneca vaccine. All in all, from Saturday, December 18 to Tuesday, December 21, a total of 9,492,500 vaccine doses arrived in the country. To the people and governments of Argentina, the United States, France, and Germany, our heartfelt gratitude, your kindness will never, ever be forgotten. Pumunta naman po tayo sa COVID-19 update ayon sa December 21, 2021 COVID-19 case bulletin ng Department of Health. Nasa 168 ang bagong kaso ng COVID sa bansa. This is a record low for this year. Nanatiling below 1% sa apat na magkakasunod na araw ang ating positivity rate. Nasa 0.9% na lamang po ito. Nasa 97.9% naman ang porsyento ng gumaling. Nasa mahigit 2.7 million ang naka-recover. Gayunpaman, inuulit po namin ang kahalagahan ng pagsunod sa health protocols natin, wear your masks, wash your hands, maintain social distancing, and get vaccinated. This is the formula that has worked to reduce our number of cases. Each element in that equation is essential for us to sustain our progress, and we urge everyone to please remain vigilant and to avoid being complacent. Sa ating mga kababayan, maraming salamat po sa inyong kooperasyon. Malungkot naman naming binabalita sa inyo na kahapon ay 10 sa ating mga kababayan ang naidagdag sa bilang ng mga pumanaw dahil sa coronavirus. Nasa 1.79% ang ating fatality rate at ito ay nananatiling mas mababa sa 2% global average. Nasa below 25% naman po ang ating hospital utilization rate. Mga kababayan, sa kabila ng mga hamon na kinakaharap natin ngayon at patuloy na magkakasama nating tinutugunan bilang isang bansa, the World Bank in its Philippines Economic Update December 2021 raised its growth forecast from 4.3% to 5.3% in 2021. It says, and I quote, alongside the progress in vaccination, the phased economic reopening will support a return of market confidence and domestic dynamism. End of quote. Similarly, the Japan Center for Economic Research, or JCER, conducted its 24th quarterly consensus survey on the Asian economies, where the Philippines is still expected to be among the best performing in the region in 2021 and 2022. The Tokyo-based think tank expects the Philippines to grow by 5.1% and growing further by 7.1% in 2022. Meanwhile, the optimism of Philippine companies over the next 12 months are at its peak since the onset of the COVID-19 pandemic in the country. According to the fourth quarter 2021 Banco Central ng Pilipinas Business Expectations Survey, business confidence index jumped from negative 5.6% in the third quarter of 2021 to 39.7% in the fourth quarter of 2021. There are several factors for this. First, the availability of more vaccines and the prospect of achieving herd immunity. Second, easing of community quarantines. Third, increase in volume and sales and orders. Fourth, improvement in economic conditions and the prospect of recovery from losses incurred during the stricter community quarantines. And fifth, the continuous decline in the number of COVID-19 cases. Just a caveat, however. Our economic team cautioned that risks to lower than projected growth are on the high side given the recent typhoon. Dito po nagtatapos ang ating presentation. Makasama naman po natin si DBM Undersecretary Kanda and Assistant Secretary Monilla ng OCD. Let's first go to ASEC Monilla for his short presentation. ASEC Monilla. Monilla on the line to show us a presentation mula sa OCD. If we can have ASEC Unilla or Monilla, if not, then can we hear from USEC Kanda? We have USEC Kanda also on the line, Undersecretary Kanda, or actually, no, that's OIC Secretary Tina Rose Marie Kanda of the Department of Budget and Management. Secretary Kanda, are you on the line? If we're having difficulty with reaching Secretary Kanda, can we go now to USEC Rocky for questions from the MPC?
Hola, Secretary Nograles, can you hear me? Opo. Although naririnig po namin si Ma'am Kanda and si ASEC Secretary, pero unahin ko na po muna yung mga tanong. Mula po kay MJ Blanca Flor ng Daily Tribune, may we ask for a palace reaction? The Philippine College of Physicians is urging daw po President Duterte to veto the proposed Vaporized Nicotine Products Regulation Act, which seeks to reduce the age limit for vaping from 21 to 18 years old. The DOH also expressed a strong opposition on the proposed measure. Similar question po yan with Lila Salaveria ng Inquirer.
Well, ayaw muna natin na pangunahan, no? Anong magiging desisyon ng Pangulo, lalo na po't hindi pa po nakakarating sa amin ang final version na ratipikado ng both House of Representatives at ng Senado, because as we know it ay magbabicameral conference committee pa po ang two houses of Congress. So wala pa po sa amin at hindi pa po namin nakikita ang final version po ng panukalang batas na yan or ng bill na yan. And so we will not speculate what the president will do until we see the final version from both houses of Congress na ratified na po ng Kongreso.
Opo. Thank you, Sir Carlo. For DBM OIC Kanda, tanong po mula kay MJ Blanca Flor, where will the government source out the 10 billion fund promised by the President in typhoon hit areas? When will it become available, and when will the President sign into law the proposed 2022 budget?
For the 10 billion pesos which the president mentioned, the 2 billion pesos is already available under the NDRIMF, which is the long name of Calamity Fund. The next 2 billion is available under the president's contingent fund, and the remainder of the 6 million will be available in a couple of days once the GAA or the General Appropriations Act is signed for 2022. No, that's the 2022 GAA. When is it going to be signed? We expect that the 2022 budget measure will be signed before the year ends. So it's between, siguro after Christmas until the 29th. These are the days that are open.
Thank you, OIC Kanda. Secretary Nograles, tanong po ni MJ Blanca Flor pa rin, meron na po bang bansa na nag-pledge ng help for our country?
Opo, yung nabanggit ko po kanina sa ating opening statement, yun po yung mga bansa so far, no? Our friends, partners from the international community that already pledged their support, their help sa ating mga kababayan for Typhoon Odette, no? Kabilang na dyan yung United Nations, United States, UK, we have Australia, Canada, China, the EU, France, Japan, Qatar. Ayan po. These are the countries, and we expect a lot more countries. Development partners and allies to come to our aid and help our kababayans na tubos na naapektuhan, no, ng Typhoon Odette.
Thank you, Secretary Carlo.
We can now go back to ASEC Munilla of OCD, who has a short presentation on the efforts of OCD to help our kababayans affected by Typhoon Odette. ASEC Manila.
Since the onslaught of affected and 6 years. It's the following effects.
We seem to have a problem with the... We'll try again later. Yusek Rocky, we'll go back to you. for more questions from the MPC and our friends from
the media. Secretary. Opo. Secretary Nograles, tanong po ni Laila Salaveria ng Inquirer, in light of the massive devastation suffered by several provinces, what will happen to the government's vaccination targets? Does Malacanang daw CA need to revise its target for this year as some LGUs may not be able to immediately conduct mass vaccinations?
Yes, the our NVOC, and this was already announced by Secretary Charlie, will continue to ramp up our vaccination efforts, and we will still continue to stick with the 54 million target by end of 2021. May bago pong in-issue ang NVOC, no, tungkol dito. If I may read, in light of the Typhoon Odette and what's happening on the ground, no? Yung National COVID-19 Vaccination Operation Center has provided the following directives for Cordillera Administrative Region, the National Capital Region, Regions 1, 2, 3, and 4A. They shall extend the implementation of Bayanihan Bakunahan National COVID-19 Vaccination Days Part 2 until December 22, 2021 and continue to intensify COVID-19 vaccination activities until December 31 of 2021. And for the regions affected by Typhoon Odette, they shall implement their Bayanihan Bakunahan National Vaccination Days Part 2 vaccination activities from December 20 to 22 and continue to intensify COVID-19 vaccination activities until December 31, 2021. And to achieve the target of fully vaccinating 54 million Filipinos by end of the year, local government units and local VOCs are mandated to prioritize the administration of due second doses and the administration of Janssen vaccines to the unvaccinated adults. Whereas all local VOCs shall be provided with new targets to meet the goal of vaccinating 54 million and are enjoined to ramp up the administration of COVID-19 vaccines until December 31, 2021, including weekends. So this is a total of 9 days. So ibig sabihin, we are mindful, aware, and sensitive to the realities on the ground, especially para dun sa mga tinamaan ng Typhoon Odette. And we know that local government units na tinamaan ng Typhoon Odette will still be very busy in all their repair, rehab, recovery efforts para sa kanilang mga kababayan. So those na hindi masyado o di gaano apektado dun sa pananalasa nitong Typhoon Odette, we will call upon them to ramp up the vaccination efforts. To those affected by Typhoon Odette, of course, the priority will be their rehab and recovery. Pero if as soon as they're ready, if they're ready within the year, and makita naman po natin na makayanan din po natin na bigyan ng konting push for the vaccination efforts doon, we will do the same. Ang bottom line po is we are sensitive to the realities on the ground. And we will adjust accordingly, mindful of what is happening right now on the ground, but mindful also that we still need to fight this COVID-19 pandemic through massive vaccination. So the target remains the same, and we will make the necessary adjustments. No, tingnan natin ano mangyayari by end of December 31, 2021. And we still have the first quarter also of 2022. If kailangan mag-catch up, then we will have to adjust accordingly.
Opo. Thank you, Secretary Carlo.
I have Maricel Halili on the line mula sa from TV5.
Hi sir, magandang tanghali po. Sir, very short lang po. First, why did it take 4 to 5 days before the president declares state of calamity in those areas affected by Typhoon Odette?
Kung naalala ninyo, yung situation briefing na ginawa ni Pangulo, which was also aired on TV, no? For the declaration of the state of calamity, we have to have a full assessment of the extent of damage done by the typhoon. But mindful of that, no, alam naman po namin, and we reminded this during the situation briefing, that local government units affected by Typhoon Odette can immediately declare a state of calamity within their own respective jurisdictions. The declaration of a state of calamity ng mga provinces, halimbawa, will enable them to also tap into their calamity funds. We were also mindful of the fact that we have in the budget quick response funds, which are available in several agencies na we can also tap, that they can also tap para sa quick response dun sa mga tinamaan ng Typhoon Odette, which we are using right now and which we continue to implement. And then because nakakuha nga tayo ng fuller assessment of the extent of damage done by Typhoon Odette from various agencies and from the personal visits ni Pangulo sa mga provinces at mga localities, then with that fuller assessment of the damage, yun yung naging basis natin for the declaration of a state of calamity. And this is what we explained during the situation briefing, and this is exactly what we did and what the president did. Kaya nga po, because of that fuller and clearer report of the extent of damage as the basis for the state of calamity, pinirmahan po kagabi ni Pangulong Duterte ang declaration of state of calamity. Again, the LGUs were able to declare their own state of calamity within their locality. We had QRF funds which we were able to tap and use, and we continue to use. And now, the state of calamity in the areas hit by, and the regions hit by Typhoon Odette.
Mm-hmm. Sir, I understand the limitations po ng mga pwedeng movement ng national government because of the effect of typhoon. But pare-pareho po kasi yung nagiging panawagan ngayon ng mga local government units like Bohol and Dinagat. Number one, ang complaint po nila, yung mga looting na nahihirapan pong mapigilan dahil kulang po sila sa PNP and AFP personnel. So they're asking for the assistance from the national government. And number two, yun pong overpriced na mga bilihin, I understand malaking tulong yung declaration ng state of calamity, but how are you going to implement that considering that even the regional DTIs are also affected by the typhoon?
Sa report po na ginawa kagabi ni Secretary Ed Anyo is nag-augment na po tayo ng mga PNP personnel. So from the different regions na hindi tinamaan ng Typhoon Odette, meron po siyang inassign na mga regions from the PNP na mag-big brother doon sa mga regions na tinamaan ng Typhoon Odette. So in his presentation kagabi, makikita natin doon yung parang one-to-one correspondence, yung kumbaga yung tinatawag niyang big brother, small brother. From one region, mag-augment dun sa isang region na tinamaan ng Odette, and another region to another region. So, meron siyang ginawang pairing. And that will address yung needs ng mga regions na yun for additional manpower from the PNP to ensure peace and order, especially dun sa areas na kung may nababalitaan po kayong or nare-report ng mga media na certain areas na may looting, I think those also are very few areas naman. It's not like in a massive scale naman. No? And we've been able to keep the peace naman and peace and order situation on the ground. And obviously, we also look up to the LGUs for that. Doon sa mga price fees, as mentioned, yung mga pag-declare ng state of calamity, whether it's a local declaration, and now with the national declaration, all the more then the price freezing will already take effect. So I also expect the DTI to follow the same route as done by PNP, ang mga national agencies naman po natin, kung saan nangangailangan ng mga augmentation ay maaari naman po natin gawin.
Sir, last na lang po, your warning or your message to those who are taking advantage of the situation imposing overpriced products and yun mga naglulut.
Yeah, even si Pangulong Duterte himself, no, in his visits, personal visits to the areas, he has given strict instructions na whether it's to the DOE, Department of Energy, or DTI, and other concerned agencies to look especially into these concerns. Yung overpricing, dumodoble na yung presyo, people taking advantage. So as far as the implementation and enforcement is concerned, may instructions sa po si Pangulo dyan. Ang sa akin na lamang siguro is ang pakiusap sa ating mga kababayan, lalong-lalo na sa panahon ngayon ng Pasko, na please let's not take advantage of our fellow Filipinos who are suffering right now. Ang panawagan po natin sa ating mga kababayan ay tulungan ang isa't isa. No, wag nating pagsamantalahin ang ating mga kababayan, lalong-lalo po yung mga nangangailangan ng tulong ngayong panahon ng Pasko.
Salamat, Secretary.
We'll go to, I think, si OCD ASEC Monilia is already ready and I think we have a better connection. ASEC Monilia?
Sir, tanghali, naririnig na po. Ay na po, ano ko. So, I would go direct sa ating ginagawa ngayon.
Medyo choppy pa po. Maybe, can you try to continue to speak?
Hello, sir. We will try another concept. Hello? So, sa ngayon po, sir, I would go direct sa mga actions na ginawa ng ating mga ahensya. With regards to the telecommunications, ito na po yung nakataas, traditional communication and set up ng DICT and OCD together with the on the compliance naman the kautusan ng kautusan ng ating please move to the next slide. So makita po natin diyan yung actions ito po sa Sandin Siargao, Vice Mayor, Operation Service Director, table to. Next slide. Ito po yung mga available ng assets na ginagamit natin sa pagdala ng ating mga logistics sa lugar. The transport company, ship, charter, 77, World Food Program, and Coast Guard has 8 vessels. The ating mga ginagawang relief efforts. Of course, the Philippine Coast Guards. On the summary of the services delivered, shown on the slide, atin po mga direct compliance to the directives. First, yung assessment damages, COA and they're still doing a Manila assessment for the Department of Agriculture. We did 333 million. The total agriculture and damage losses, damage and losses sa lahat ng affected. For the shoot, nagpadala po sila ng 1,000 sheets ng tarpaulin sa Surigao del Norte and Islands and another 1,000 tarpaulin sheets to Tarag. For the SWD and OCD, they are conducting this directive. As the basis manager in Island, meron po tayong teams doon. And we OCD the following items, 5,000 hygiene kits and also surgical masks. The Philippine Coast Guard have deployed the following assets like PRP Gabriela Silang, Sindangan, and Agustin. And likewise, the ARP, ARP Iwak, and Ibatan. Again, the PRP ang Pangulo departed Manila to Siargao 19 December 2021 by the needed assistance. So, initially po, nagdala ito ng mga relief ko. Then, DOH will provide the money for the... Kasi, those po, like, DOH mobilized their medical trauma response team and health logistics and Surigao del Norte, they already sent for Siargao 460,000. Marina has activated all the specials and ferry relief. So, assets na nila. Vessels po, companies, shipping companies. For DPWH, ito na po yung kanilang road clearings. By assets, 300. And as well as provided immediate response fund, 100 million. Region 6, 7, 8. 10 and 13, Skarag. Then for DSWD provided 14 million worth of assistance to all the affected areas. It is still continuing. Marami pa pinadala tayo ang Philippine Air Force C-130 aircraft ay patuloy po pagdala ng affected issued and validation and so on for the provision. We are also kakipat po dun sa recommended natin sa state of calamity is the conduct of the post-disaster needs assessment para mas mapadali po kagad ng rehabilitation effort dito sa mga affected. For DA, 1.35 billion worth of readily available assistance. Again, for the recommendation po, council, the declaration of the state of calamity, nabanggit. Kasama po dyan is recommendation, acceptance of first kind of testing. Next slide.
Thank you very much. Because of that, then may I therefore read yung proclamation number 1267. This is by the President of the Philippines, proclamation number 1267, declaring a state of calamity in regions 4B, 6, 7, 8, 10, and 13. Whereas last 16 to 19 December 2021, Typhoon Odette, international code name Rai, caused widespread devastation and damage to houses, infrastructure, properties, and agriculture, and resulted in the disruption of critical lifelines of Filipinos in areas affected by the typhoon. Whereas pursuant to Republic Act number 10121 or the Philippine Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Act of 2010, the National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council issued Resolution Number 11, Series of 2021, recommending the declaration of a state of calamity over areas severely and adversely affected by Typhoon Odette. Whereas the declaration of a state of calamity will hasten the rescue, relief, and rehabilitation efforts of government and the private sector, including any international humanitarian assistance. And whereas this declaration will, among others, effectively control the prices of basic goods and commodities in the affected areas and afford the national government as well as local government units ample latitude to utilize appropriate funds for rescue, recovery, relief, and rehabilitation of and the continuation of basic services to affected populations in accordance with law. Now, therefore, I, Rodrigo Roa Duterte, President of the Philippines, by virtue of the powers vested in me by the Constitution and existing laws, do hereby declare a state of calamity in Regions 4B, 6, 7, 8, 10, and 13. All departments and other concerned government agencies are hereby directed to implement and execute rescue, recovery, relief, and rehabilitation work in accordance with pertinent operational plans and directives. All departments and other concerned government agencies are also hereby directed to coordinate with and provide or augment the basic services and facilities of affected LGUs, law enforcement agencies, with the support of the armed forces of the Philippines, are hereby directed to undertake all necessary measures to ensure peace and order in affected areas as may be necessary. The state of calamity shall remain in force and effect for 1 year unless sooner lifted in accordance with law. In witness whereof, I have hereunto set my hand and caused the seal of the Republic of the Philippines to be affixed, done in the city of Manila this 21st day of December in the year of our Lord 2021, signed by President Rodrigo Roa Duterte. Yusek Rocky, the proclamation number is proclamation number 1267. Proclamation number 1267. Yusek Rocky?
Yes, thank you, Sec. Carlos. Tanong po para kay OIC Kanda, mula po kay Trish Terada. How much funds do we have left, considering po the most of these have been used for COVID response?
For the NDREAM F, no, we still have a remainder of around 4 billion pesos at the moment. Yun yung pwedeng gamitin. Kasi misleading yun kung halimbawa ibibigay natin yung total na available under the budget for this year, kasi hindi naman pwedeng gamitin lahat yon for the purpose of augmenting yung pangangailangan para sa pagsalanta ng Odette, no? So yun yung available under NDREAM F, and kung halimbawa nga kakailanganin pa, pwedeng gamitin yung contingent fund, which is for emergency and new activities and programs, no? Unexpected pati. So yun yung available this year.
Oh, thank you, Sec. Carlo. Tanong po mula kay Trish Terada ng CNN Philippines, na-receive na po ba ng Malacanang yung enrolled budget for 2022 and kailan ito expected na mapirmahan ng Pangulo? Similar question with Sam Edenilla ng Business Mirror at si Jopel Peleño ng DWIC.
Per Malacanang records, hindi pa po nakakarating sa amin. So we'll continue to monitor the Malacanang records and see if darating ba within the day, today or tomorrow. But according to our Malacanang records, wala pa po.
Secretary Carlo, tanong po yung susunod pong tanong ni Laila Salaverria ng Inquirer, nasagot na po ni OIC Canada about the 10 billion na pesos fund. Similar question po yan with Lanes Capanti ng GMA News and ni John Montemayor ng Malaya. From Laila Salaverria ng Inquirer, Secretary Carlo, how does the palace address those who question why the declaration of the state of calamity was only made on Tuesday when several provinces had been suffering for days?
As I mentioned already, as early as a situation briefing, we already apprised the local government units that they can, on their own, the provinces, local government units can on their own declare a state of calamity. Number two, we already have quick response funds in the budget that can be utilized and which was in fact utilized in our response efforts dun sa mga areas na tinamaan ng Typhoon Odette. Number three, yung kinakailangan natin na fuller and more complete assessment of the damage, extent of the damage in Typhoon Odette was necessary for the basis, no, to lay the basis for the declaration of state of calamity, which the president did and signed yesterday, December 21. So, yun po. Those were the three steps that we implemented, mindful again that all of these were set in place and set into motion according to what was needed.
Po. Tanong pa rin po sa Carlo mula kay Laila Salaverria na Inquirer. The President daw po mentioned that he believes the use of face shields has been effective and he advised the public to still use this. Does the administration plan to make a face shields mandatory again, especially given the President's concerns about Omicron?
Yung alert level 2 guidelines po natin very clearly state na yung face shields are voluntary except in health care settings and hospital settings. So yun lang po yung mandatory. Yung sinabi po ni Pangulo kagabi is just a reminder to people that it's voluntary. At dahil na yung banta ng Omicron at yung ito nga ilaban natin against COVID-19, the face shield still acts as an additional layer. So, kumbaga, as a good father of the family, ang paalala lang ni Pangulo is if you wanna be really fully protected, bagamat voluntary pa yung face shields, that is still an added layer of protection against COVID, whatever variant, including yung Omicron variant.
Tanong sa Carlo mula kay Celerina Monte ng NHK, will the government declare a unilateral ceasefire with the CPP, NPA, NDF during this holiday season? Why and why not?
No advice yet to that effect.
Question from Sam Medenilla ng Business Mirror. I think natanong na ito, Secretary, about dun sa gustong i-veto ni Presidente sa budget bill legislation. Yung second question po niya, nabanggit ni Secretary Duque na expected na daw po na ang current generation ng COVID vaccines na ginagamit will be less effective for new COVID-19 variants. Itutuloy pa din ng government ang pagbili ng additional doses ng nasabing vaccines or are there efforts para maghanap po ng new generation of vaccines for next year?
Yung tungkol dun sa budget bill, we cannot again speak to that yet kasi hindi pa natin nakikita yung final version. We are still awaiting sa the arrival of the final version ng budget bill as ratified by the House and the Senate before the President can act on it. So we don't want to speculate until we obviously get a copy of the budget. As to the second question, of course, we still need to procure the vaccines for 2022. We expect that item in the budget will still be there. We hope that the budget, as approved by the House and the Senate, still contains that allocation for additional vaccines procurement for 2022, because we will still need to cover our kababayans with that additional protection ng bakuna. But again, be mindful that bakuna by itself is not a complete layer of protection. It is bakuna plus mask, hugas, iwas. And if you look at the other countries na nakikita natin yung pagtaas ng bilang ng COVID cases and even hospitalizations, it's because many of them, after getting vaccinated, nakalimutan itong tatlo. Hindi pwede yan. Itong tatlo, mask, hugas, iwas, plus bakuna, yan po ay together. And so, anumang variant yan, Omicron man or kung anuman variant, that we will be facing in year 2022, yung bakuna is effective to shield us against severe and critical COVID-19 disease. But yung pag-spread ng COVID-19 would be mitigated and stopped even if we do all four. Yan yung combination na kinakailangan. Hindi pwede mawala ang isa sa apat dyan.
Tanong mula po kay MJ Blanca Flor ng Daily Tribune for OIC Kanda. Nasagot na po ni Yusek Kanda yung 10 billion pesos. Pati po yung kung kailan masasign into law yung proposed 2022 budget. Yung second question po niya, considering the massive damage caused by the typhoon, can the government finish the rehabilitation efforts within the remaining months of the Duterte administration?
I think
we will work on this as fast as possible. Obviously, this administration is only up to June 30 of 2022. So kung ano yung pwede naming simulan, anong pwede nating tapusin, given the extent of the damage, given all of the recovery and rehabilitation efforts that we need to put in place, begin, start, and complete within 6 months, kung anong makakayanan natin, gagawin po natin. Ang lahat ng kaya natin gawin. But we are facing this challenge plus the challenge of totally eradicating COVID-19 plus the threats of other variants. At the end of the day, kailangan po natin lahat magtulungan dito. Hindi lang pwede na nakahatang lamang sa balikat ng iilan o ng pamahalan lamang. Kinakailangan po natin ng suporta at tulong ng bawat isang Pilipino para dito. So we commit to work hard and fast. And we'll try to complete whatever we can. But at the end of the day, once we turn this over to the next administration, marami na po kaming nasimulan, may mga natapos na, may mga nagawa na, at sana ay pagpatuloy lamang ng susunod na administration ang lahat ng mga ito.
Opo. Yung susunod pong tanong ni MJ Blanca Flor ay nasagot niya na, Secretary, about the face shields. Yung tanong naman po ni Jopel Peleño ng DWIC ay nasagot niya na rin about yung tulong o pondo, na kung sasapat po yung pondo about nung sa bagyo. Yung tanong po ni Lanes Capanti for USEC OIC Kanda, the President said these funds will be distributed to affected areas by Friday. Is this a final timeline, OIC Kanda?
Wala pa kong ganong commitment na madidistribute by Friday kasi tinitingnan pa nga yung total damage. So hindi pa natin alam kung paano i-distribute siya, kung magkano ang distribution per region and local government unit kung kinakailangan. In the meantime, magkakaroon po ng pondo rin na sa pagtulong dahil nga meron naman quick response fund ang mga ahensya, yung mga frontline agencies.
Opo. From Lanes Capanti ng GMA News online, Sec. Carlo, is the palace aware of situation in Consolacion, Cebu? No? Drinking water and food supply is running thin.
Before I answer that, idadagdag ko lang dun sa sagot ni Sec Kanda. Yung instruction ni Pangulo was for USEC Halad, no? To be able to complete the necessary paperwork needed, the estimates, the how much needed to implement for the NDRIM fund or the calamity fund. Yun po yung instructions at yun po yung narinig natin sa Talk to the People ni Pangulong Duterte kagabi, yung instructions sa kay Undersecretary Halad ng OCD para sa lalong madaling panahon ma-implement na po yung lahat ng kinakailangan. But again, no, it's not like hanggang dun lang. Like what OIC Secretary Kanda said, tuloy-tuloy yan. From now until end of the year, and then may bagong budget po na darating sa susunod na taon, 2022. So, kumbaga, meron din tayong basis for releasing funds, some more funds for the continuing recovery, rehab, repair efforts na kinakailangan natin on the ground dun sa tinamaan ng Typhoon Odette. So, ano man ang meron tayo from the QRF, gagamitin natin yung QRF na yan, kung ano yung pwede for the NDRIM Calamity Fund, gagamitin natin for all those efforts. Kung ano yung from the contingency, gagamitin natin up to the end of 2021. And then sa 2022, bagong budget, may bagong GAA tayo. So may bagong basis naman tayo for additional funding for the continuous efforts that we're doing. For those that were devastated by Typhoon Odette. Sa Consolacion, I don't know if we can ask Asek Monilla to comment. Maybe Asek Monilla, if he's still on the line, the question is on our efforts to help our kababayans in Consolacion, Cebu.
Yes, sir. The same manner with the other places po sa Cebu, natin po mga ahensya doon, patuloy pa rin po, especially just na po, na maipabot ang kanilang mga ayuda doon ating mga kababayan. So, our region has actually assisted sa damage assessment na kanila ginawa and ongoing effort na mga ahensya on the response effort sa hindi lang sa Consolacion Cebu but also all other areas na.
Opo. Sir Carlo, tanong mula kay
yung on the ground, the LGUs are already doing their quick response, no, efforts. DSWD is augmenting response efforts ng Consolacion. We will direct the OCD to also take a look at ano pang mga pangangailangan. I think the request is water, no? So, anyway, ipa-ano namin yan. Patutukan natin yan sa DSWD at sa OCD.
Apo. Sir Carlo, tanong mula kay Joe Montemayor na Joe Montemayor ng Malaya for OIC Kanda, DOH daw po ay asking for augmentation of their QRF. When will it be given? And will QRF of other agencies such as DSWD and DA also be augmented? And will DBM daw po augment? Is there enough funds available for QRF augmentation for USEC, for OIC Kanda?
Yes. Yung pag-augment kasi ng NDREAMF, ang quick response fund, almost automatic yan pag critical level na. Ngayon, yung sa DOH, wala pa kaming request na natatanggap ngayon na for augmentation. Ang aming nababalitaan lang ay DSWD. So doon naman sa QRF, madalas kami mag-augment. Kamukha na sa DA, nakapag-augment kami out of their 1 billion, nag-augment na kami dati, no? Ng 1.75. So, hindi problema yon. Ang pag-augment kasi ng QRF, kinukuha yon sa doon sa main, no, NDREAMF. So, once na may critical level yan, i-request ng agency yan, and automatically we release the amount.
Thank you, OIC Kanda. Si Carlo, may pahabol ng tanong si Danes Capanti ng GMA News. Confirm ba PR President Duterte will sign proposed 2022 budget on December 28th?
Again, we will give you a more definitive date as we continue to monitor with Malacañang Records kung kailan darating yung final version ng budget. So once we receive the final version of the budget as ratified by both houses of Congress, then it will go through a vetting process. Doon pa namin talagang masasabi kung kailan mapipirmahan yan. Because it will have to pass through the vetting process in Malacañang as soon as we receive it. But obviously, we all know the urgency. Having said that, please also remember, you know, yung dun sa tanong ng QRF na nasagot naman ni OIC Secretary Kanda, pagdating po ng 2022, there will be a new budget. With that new budget is the basis, no, for the fund requirements, including the QRF.
Opo. Tanong mula kay Cecil Morelia ng AFP. If President Duterte approved the NDRRMC recommendation to accept foreign typhoon or debt assistance?
Yung as stated dun sa proclamation on the declaration of a state of calamity, that state of calamity also allows, in fact, facilitates our repair, recovery, and rehab efforts, not only for government, but also for the international community. To aid us and help us here as we all move towards our recovery efforts for those na lubos na naapektuhan ng Typhoon Odette.
Opo, last two questions na lang po si Carlo. Tanong po mula kay Mads, kay Miguel Aguana ng GMA News Desk. Senator Drilon says he is saddened daw po over the president's statement that the government has no money to assist typhoon victims. He says government can tap park funds of government agencies and GOCCs. Senator Angaro, on the other hand, says President Duterte can realign 2021 savings. Your comment po, do we have enough money to assist the victims?
Yes, we have enough money, and the president already directed, no, number one, yung sa 10 billion nga na kinakailangan. Of course, it will not stop there, when the president made those statements, it was, remember, in the context of informing the Filipino nation, ating mga kababayan, that marami talaga tayong mga challenges in terms of meron tayong COVID na malaki na talaga, malaki ang gastos for COVID. So, and if you listen to the speeches of the president, that's what he says. No? We've spent so much for efforts against COVID, spent so much for vaccines, at ito, meron naman another challenge itong Typhoon Odette. But we, in the government, in his administration, will look for all ways and means in order to address all of the challenges, all of the concerns, lahat ng mga pangangailangan ng ating mga kababayan. In that context, para maunawaan lamang ng ating mga kababayan na this is not an easy task, but we all have to help each other, no? Hindi lamang government, kundi lahat ng ating mga kababayan. Kami nagpapasalamat sa mga kababayan natin, private sector, the private companies, even ordinary Filipino individuals who on their own, through their own initiatives or through various efforts have really shown tong bayanihan spirit to help each other and to help one another. So, yun po yung panawagan. Lahat po tayong magtutulungan. And we also thank our allies in the international community who have already, as we speak, no, already pledged and offered their assistance to us. So, lahat po ng tulong na kinakailangan ay welcome naman po ang lahat ng yan. So, lahat po tayo magtulungan dito. Yun lang naman po ang mensahe ng ating Pangulo. But yes, as much as we can, and OIC Secretary Kanda will also bear me out here and say na lahat ng efforts na kinakailangan natin to secure the budget necessary for all of these things that we need, no? All of the response and recovery efforts that we need, hinahanapan natin lahat ng paraan. We have battled COVID-19. We have looked for the funds, searched the funds, and were able to generate the funds necessary for COVID-19. Ang sinasabi lamang ng Pangulo, meron tayong Typhoon Odette, may COVID-19, may Typhoon Odette, pero we will do everything necessary to fight these and overcome these challenges. Kahit ilang fronts pa yan. There are many fronts, many challenges, but we will all overcome these.
Last question, Secretary Carlo. Mula pa rin po kay Miguel Aguana ng GMA News Desk, Senator Lacson proposed that NDRRMC should be convened immediately so cabinet members can mobilize their QRFs. OCD should be required to submit their post-disaster needs assessment to guide the president to prioritize aid, while DFA should meet Ambassador to appeal to the international community for assistance.
Being done po. All being done. Yung sa situation briefer, immediately na kinonvene ni Pangulo, during the situation briefer, then immediately nag-convene yung council. That's the reason why we have the state of calamity. The president is doing personal visits, making personal assessments, making personal calls. He's hands-on in everything and all of the departments. Kita niya naman, mga department secretaries go with him on the ground. Lahat ng mga needs assessment, lahat ng mga pag-compute at pag-estimate ng mga lahat ng mga pangangailangan ay ginagawa po natin on the ground. The QRF is already being utilized. So everything that needs to be done is already being done. And we continue to call upon our kababayans to lend a helping hand, lalong-lalo na sa panahon ng Pasko, sa lahat ng nangangailangan. Let's all do what we can to help one another, especially those who are greatly, greatly, severely affected by this devastating Typhoon Odette. So magtulungan po tayo, tulungan natin ang lahat ng mga nangangailangan ng tulong. Government is on top of the situation. We are doing everything in terms of budget, the necessary moves, the necessary actions, lahat po yan. And as I said, even the president is making his personal visits as we speak. The president will be making his visits to the Dinagat Islands and to Siargao to personally assess the situation and to personally lend a helping hand and to give his presidential directives to the concerned government agencies.
Thank you, Sir Carlo, sa ating mga bisita at sa MPC. Thank you po.
Maraming salamat sa iyo, Yusek Rocky, at kay Asek Monilia, kay OIC Secretary Kanda, at sa lahat ng mga kaibigan natin sa Malacañang Press Corps at sa media. Again, advanced Merry Christmas po sa inyo lahat. Mga kababayan, marami po sa atin ang nasa lanta at kasalukuyang humaharap sa pagsubok na dala ng pananalasa ng Bagyong Odette. Magkaisa po sana tayong lahat upang makatulong sa abot ng ating makakaya para sa ating mga kababayan. Ang inyong pamahalaan ay hindi tumitigil upang pagulungin ang buong mekanismo ng gobyerno sa layuning ibsan ang epekto ng nagdaang bagyo sa buhay at kabuhayan ng ating mga kababayan. Sa pagtatapos, nais kong ihabilin ito. Sa kabila ng maraming hamon na ating kinakaharap ngayon, nananatili ang ating panawagan, kailangan nating magkaisa at magtulungan. Ito ang tunay na diwa ng Kapaskuhan. Maraming salamat po.